Good day everyone, I'm your Mr. ATL and welcome back to my channel. So today's video, we're going to discuss graphing inverse functions. So let me read first. The graph of inverse function can be obtained by reflecting the graph about the line y equals x. Okay, so pwede raw natin makuha ang inverse ng function given the graph. Basta i-reflect lang natin yung graph about the line y equals x. In other words, it is the reflection of the graph of the original function where the axis of symmetry is the line y equals x. So, yung reflection daw ng graph doon sa original function, pati nung inverse function, ay yung line na y equals x. So, later on, makikita natin kung saan ang line y equals x. So, keep in mind that the graph must pass the horizontal and the vertical line test to declare that it shows one-to-one function and has an inverse function. Okay, so para raw malaman kung ito raw ay one-to-one function, dapat daw yung graph daw ay papasa sa vertical line test at sa horizontal line test, na kung saan ang vertical line at horizontal line ay mag-i-intersect sa graph at exactly one point. For example, the graphs of set A equals 4, 6, 3, 4, 2, 2, 0, 1, negative 2, 0 are reflections of its inverses. A inverse equals 6, 4, 4, 3, 2, 2, 1, 0, negative 2, 0 with respect to the line y equals x. So, yung set A, kapag ginraph ito or pinlot ito sa Cartesian plane, magiging reflection niya ay yung inverse niya with respect to the line y equals x. So, let me show you kung ano mangyayari kapag naplot ito sa Cartesian plane. Okay, ito yung graph ng original function, yung 4, 6, 3, 4, 2, 2, 0, 1, negative 2, 0. So, susunod naman, ipapakita natin yung graph ng inverse nitong original function, na kung saan i-interchange lang natin yung x and y coordinates. Okay, ito naman ang graph ng inverse ng original function, na kung saan in-interchange natin yung x and y coordinates. Una, naging 6, 4, 3, 4, 2, 2, 1, 0, 0, negative 2. So, nasaan ngayon ang line of reflection or the y equals x? Okay, so ito na ngayon ang graph ng original function at yung inverse niya. So, kung titingnan mo, may makikita kang broken line dito na may pangalan na y equals x. So, ito yung kanyang line of reflection or the axis of symmetry. Let's say for example, itong paper na to ay isang graphing paper. Kung ifo-fold natin ang paper na ito, na kung saan ang pinakagitna niya yung broken line or yung y equals x, magtatapat-tapat or magko-coincide yung mga points at yung kanilang inverses. For example, yung 4, 6, magiging katapat niya yung 6, 4. Okay? Yung 0, negative 2, magiging katapat niya si negative 2, 0. Okay, so nakita natin that the graph of inverse function can be formed by graphing the original function and sketching the graph of its inverse. Okay, so meron tayong task. Given the function f of x equals negative 2x plus 3, gagawin natin tong 9 na tasks na ito. So letter A, construct a table of values. Okay, so sa table of values, ilagay natin yung value ni x, na kung saan ito ay negative 3, negative 2, negative 1, 0, 1, 2, 3. And sa f of x, isisolve natin siya ngayon gamit yung function na f of x equals negative 2x plus 3. Okay, when x equals negative 3, So f of negative 3 equals negative 2 times negative 3 plus 3. Multiply muna natin yung negative 2 and negative 3, that is positive 6. Bring down 3. 6 plus 3 is 9. When x equals negative 2, f of negative 2 equals negative 2 times negative 2 plus 3. Multiply negative 2 times negative 2, that is positive 4. Bring down 3. 4 plus 3 equals 7. When x equals negative 1, f of negative 1 equals negative 2 times negative 1 plus 3. Multiply negative 2 times negative 1, that is positive 2. Bring down 3. Then 2 plus 3, that is equals to 5. Okay, next. When x equals 0, f of negative 1 equals negative 2 times 0 plus 3. So negative 2 times 0, that is 0. Bring down 3. And 0 plus 3, that is positive 3. Okay, next, when x equals 1, f of 1 equals negative 2 times 1 plus 3. Multiply muna yung negative 2 and 1, that is negative 2. Bring down 3. Negative 2 plus 3, subtract, that is 1. So, next, when x equals 2, f of 2 equals negative 2 times 2 plus 3. Negative 2 times 2 is negative 4. Bring down 3. That is subtraction again. Mas mataas si negative 4. So, negative 1. And when x equals positive 3, f of 3 equals to negative 2 times 3 plus 3. Negative 2 times 3, that is negative 6. Bring down positive 3. So, negative 6 plus 3. Subtraction again. So, that is negative 3. Okay. So, this is now the answer in letter A. We were able to construct a table of values with the function f of x equals to negative 2x plus 3. So let's go to the next task, letter B. Okay, so we're done already with letter A. Let's go to letter B. Generate the ordered pairs. Okay, so using the table of values, ordered pairs can be generated as follows. Negative 3, 9, negative 2, 7, negative 1, 5, 0, 3, 1, 1, 2, negative 1, 3, negative 3. So, mula doon sa mga x values, yun yung mga first na coordinate. Okay, so done na tayo dito sa letter B. Next naman, letter C. Sketch the graph of f of x. Yung sa mga y values naman, ito yung mga nasa second coordinate. So, madali lang siya. Okay, so bali, ito na yung graph ng ating function f of x equals to negative 2x plus 3. As you can see, meron na siyang arrowheads on both sides dahil ang ating graph ng y equals negative 2x plus 3 ay mag-extend on both directions. Let's say you will use x equals to positive 4. So, magiging y equals to negative 8 plus 3, that is negative 5. So, magkakaroon na naman ng value si y or si f of x and so on. So, therefore, it can be extended on both directions. Okay, so done na tayo sa letter C. Let's go na to letter D. Find the dominant range of f of x. Okay, by looking at the graph, the domain of the function is the set of all real numbers. Also, the range is the set of real numbers since it is a linear function, where its graph goes definitely as high or as low without any limits. In interval notation, the domain of f of x, or in symbol, d sub f equals negative infinity to positive infinity. The range of f of x in symbol r of x equals to negative infinity until positive infinity. Okay, so let's go now to letter E. We will find the f inverse of x. Okay, so the given is f of x equals to negative 2x plus 3. So let us change first the f of x into y. So that will become y equals to negative 2x plus 3. Then let us interchange the x and y. So that will become x equals to negative 2y plus 3. And then let us solve for y in terms of x. So the first thing that I am going to do is to transpose the negative 2y to the left side and then transpose the positive x to the right side. So that will become 2y equals to negative x plus 3, and then divide both sides by positive 2, that will become y equals to negative x plus 3 all over 2. Then change y into f inverse of x. So the f inverse of x equals to negative x plus 3 all over 2. Okay, we're done with letter E. Let's go now to letter F. We will construct a table of values for F inverse of X. Okay, so pwede na lang naman natin na baligtarin yung X values and Y values. So, let us just see kung tama. So, when X equals to 9, F inverse of 9 equals to negative 9 plus 3 all over 2. Negative 9 plus 3 is negative 6. Pag dinivide natin yan sa 2, ang mangyayari is negative 3. So, tama ito, no? Dahil naipagpalit lang naman yan yung 9 and 3. Next, when X equals 7, F inverse of 7 equals to negative 7 plus 3 all over 2. Negative 7 plus 3, ma-minus natin, magiging negative 4 over 2. So, divide, that will be negative 2. Okay, so this is correct also. Next, when X equals 5, F inverse of 5 equals to negative 5 plus 3 all over 2. So, negative 5 plus 3, that is negative 2. 2, divide natin sa 2, magiging negative 1. So, 1. Next, when X equals to 3, so F inverse of 3 equals to negative 3 plus 3 all over 2. And negative 3 plus 3 is 0. Kasi susubtract lang natin siya. So, 0 divided by 2, that is 0. Okay? Next, when X equals 1, so F inverse of 1 equals to negative 1 plus 3 all over 2. So, negative 1 plus 3, subtract, that is positive 2. And 2 divided by 2, that is positive 1. Next, when X equals negative 1, so that is F inverse of negative 1 equals to, may negative 1 kasi sa labas, so magiging negative times negative 1 plus 3. Negative times negative is positive, so 1 plus 3 is 4. Divide by 2, that will become positive 2. Okay, next, when X equals to negative 3, so F inverse of negative 3 equals to, may negative ulit sa labas, so negative times negative 3 plus 3. So, negative times negative is positive, 3 plus 3, 6. Divide by 2, that will become positive 3. Okay, so we're done already with letter F. So, let's go to letter G. Generate the ordered pairs for F inverse of X. Okay, so using the table of values, ordered pairs can be generated as follows. So, we have 9, negative 3, 7, negative 2, 5, negative 1, 3, 0, 1, 1, negative 1, 2, negative 3, 3. So, pwede na lang natin i-interchange yung X and Y. Okay, so we're done already with letter G. Let's go to letter H. We will sketch the graph of F inverse of X. Okay, so bali, ito na yung ating graph of y equals to negative x plus 3 all over 2. So, makikita nyo meron din siyang arrowhead on both directions since it can be extended on those sides. Okay, pinagsama ko na yung dalawang graph. Ito yung y equals to negative 2x plus 3, yung original function. So, ito yung graph niya. At yung pangalawa naman, yung graph ng inverse ng y equals to negative x plus 3. So, ito yung inverse function, yung graph. At ito naman yung line of reflection or the axis of symmetry, which is the y equals x. That is the broken line, yung nasa gitna. Okay, we're done with letter H. We can now find the domain and range of F inverse of x. Okay, so the domain of the function is the set of all real numbers. Also, the range is the set of all real numbers. So, in interval notation, domain of F inverse of X, or in symbol, D sub F inverse equals to negative infinity to positive infinity. Okay, so range of F inverse of X, in symbol, R F inverse equals to negative infinity until positive infinity. So, ganun din ang kanyang domain and range since ang ating function ay still linear function. Also, the domain of the function is the range of its inverse, and the range of the function is the domain of its inverse. So, nagkakabali-baliktad din yung domain and range ng function at ng kanilang inverse. Okay, it's your turn. So, let us see if you can do the same thing. So, given the function g of x equals to negative 7x plus 4, you are going to do the following tasks. So, there are 9. So, you can do that. Okay, so that's all for today. I hope you enjoy learning about the graph of the inverse function. And before I end up my video, I would like to give my special thanks to Mr. LT and Daligan. And I hope you learned something. Goodbye!